Friday, everyone. Welcome back to Sunrise. We are talking rodeo this morning. I'm joined by Dan Fowley, the rodeo announcer. It's so fun talking to you every year and so happy to have you back. And it's on. The show is on.
Yeehaw! We're doing it.
Yes, we're doing it. Yeah. So tell me a little bit, what was your excitement finding out? You know, normally every year you're used to coming back, but this one might have been a little bit different.
Yeah, it was a lot of stuff, like for all of us, has been up in the air, you know, and thank goodness with the hoops and whatnot that the committee jumped through and under the protocol of the CDC and the local county here, and along with help from the Professional Rodeo Cowboys Association, we've dotted all our I's and crossed all our T's, and you know, we've got things working in our advantage in an outdoor venue like we have, and plenty of places to social distance and really enjoy a good time. And it, this year really embodies what rodeo is all about, Dominique. You know, it's about communities coming together and getting to see one another. And I can't think of a more special year than this to give me, and it's the 76th year of this great celebration.
Big number.
Boom.
And we were just talking about a little bit, you know, you're so good at what you do.
Oh,
and
you're so kind.
Yes, and what makes you keep coming back? I know you said the weather's great. You can't beat the weather, especially this time and now, but what's some things that make you keep wanting to come back?
What this rodeo does for this community. Of course, this rodeo, and especially this year, it's an all-star lineup of the Cowboys. Some of the very best in our sport are here trying to, you know, with a little bit of uncertainty from last year, it's proved at point a lot of Cowboys don't really start their season till dead of summer. This year they know the importance of jumping on board, and pretty much all the Cowboys that won money here last year advanced to the national finals, the Super Bowl of rodeos. And we're partnered this year with Amberlee's Place, and it's to bring awareness to a very troubling statistic of domestic violence. And tomorrow we celebrate something that's really important to a lot of us on the Yuma committee. It's the Wrangler Tough Enough to Wear Pink campaign, where it's to raise funds and awareness to stamp out cancer, and which has affected a lot of our rodeo family.
Oh yeah.
And then on Sunday afternoon, we pay homage to the men and women that protect this great nation in which we live and honor our military.
Nice. So overall, it's a great event. It's very entertaining, but then you're also giving back, you know, to the community, good causes, and it's so much fun. And we have you on the big mic. You can't beat that.
You were so kind. Well, there's a downside to everything, I guess. I'm here, but you know, the weather's great, and it's going to be fun. And how blessed are we this weekend, the way the weather kind of, after a pretty scorching Easter Sunday, record setting,
it's gonna
be a great time to come out and watch great Cowboys and Cowgirls and celebrate not only our sport of rodeo, but our heritage as Americans coming together and getting to enjoy our neighbors.
Couldn't have said it better. Yep, that's Dan again. Thanks, Dan. I'm so excited to be seeing you this weekend. Everyone come out. You can hear his voice on the big mic. Give us a little taste what to expect.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to one of the most prestigious rodeos in the world.
All right. You can't beat that. That just makes you want to go. Get your tickets now. You can head over to our website at kyma.com to pick up those tickets. They're also available at the door in case you can't get them on the line. Thanks for tuning in with us. And it's time to rodeo. We'll see you this weekend. Dan, thank you again.
Yippee-ki-yay.
Yippee-ki-yay. Thank you.